So we're starting with some lukewarm water and our yeast. And now we're going to add our mixture of olive oil and apple cider vinegar. And to this, we are adding our premix of the dries, which is the Tuscany blend flour, salt, baking powder, and sugar. And lastly, we are going to add our water. Our dough's been mixing for about 2 minutes on high speed. And let's feel it. Now that feels perfect. If you can see, it's like really sticky. It's almost like a shortcut crust pastry or like a sugar cookie pastry. And you can see when I stick my thumbs into it, it sticks a little bit to my thumbs. It's still much, much more sticky than a regular pizza dough. And here you can see, just to get a sense of what it should look like and what it feels like. I'm taking some of my Tuscany blend out here just to dust my work surface, since my dough is sticky and I don't want it sticking to my table. And I'm just rolling this ball of dough. You can see how pliable it is and how easy it is to shape. So even if your dough is really sticky, don't worry. You just roll it in some flour and put some flour on top, and it will still give you this nice flexible dough. So after our dough's been proofing in the oven for about a half an hour, it's nice and fluffy to the touch. I'm gonna split it in half for our two different pizza crusts. So one way to roll out your dough, and this is if your dough is not too wet, is to take the flour, put it on your board, take your ball of dough and roll it into a nice ball, coat it with some more flour. We're gonna take our rolling pin, start from the center, and roll out like you would a pie crust, continuing to add flour to the surface of your dough and to your work surface to prevent it from sticking. We're gonna just take the rolling pin again like you would do with a pie crust. And it's not sticking to the bottom of my surface because I covered it with flour. I have oil on my pizza pan. I oiled it with olive oil. And now I'm just sliding that down like that. And we'll take some of the excess oil from the tray and just spread it on top here. And this method works better if your ball of dough is a little bit more wet. This dough is much more sticky than that other ball that we rolled out with a rolling pin. And we spread oil all over the bottom of the pizza pan. And we're gonna take our ball of dough, stick it in the center, flatten it out. Our hands are coated with oil as well. And we're just using our hands to press out the dough. And continue to coat your hand with oil and make sure the bottom of the pan has enough oil. And you're just pressing down and out. Again, if your pan was smaller, you would just push it out to the edges of the pan. I would suggest par baking the crust first and then adding your toppings, your sauce, your cheese, and then putting it back in the oven to bake. If you have any more questions, you can email me at orly@blendsbyorly.com or visit my website for more baking tips and tricks.